out of my way.
What? Are you protecting the dragon?
She's not a dragon!
Huh?
Back off, or I'll make you back off.
And just check out how much malevolence it's putting out.
Which means it's not a Therian.
Let's retreat. We've got no reason to pick a fight with something we can't handle.
I do.
Oh, you're up for it?
What? What are you doing? She's right. Fighting this creature is a good way to end up dead. Sorry.
Well, no turning back now.
Damn it, this wasn't part of the plan.
Yeah, but training like this doesn't come around every day.
Be on your guard. One wrong move and you're done for.
I know. That's the fun part.
Hey, it's up! Hold up!
Yeah. This one definitely puts up a better fight than your average demon.
Is there any hope of actually defeating this thing?
I'll do whatever it takes. That's my way. Sabine!
Yeah. I see you're out for blood, as usual. You knew, didn't you, Aizen?
Out of my way.
What? Are you protecting the dragon?
She's not a dragon!
Huh?
Back off, or I'll make you back off. Got away.
That hurts, babe. And here we hadn't seen each other in so long.
Hold it. Is that dragon someone you knew?
I told you, she's not a dragon.
Check out my pecs, and the dragon have some kind of close ties. Did I hear you right? We're talking about a dragon here. I know what I said, but how could that be?
When Malakim are tainted by malevolence, a dragon is what ultimately results.
So you're saying that dragon was a Malak Zavid once knew? She must be who he was praying for back in town.
Yeah, most likely.
But do Malakim put out malevolence like humans do?
No. Not by themselves, they don't. But if one remains in contact with humans or demons who do, it will eventually taint her, and she will become a dragon.
What about you, kiddo? You feel anything weird after you got thrown into the Earth Pulse at the Empyrean's throne?
I did, yeah.
Can't say I'm surprised. The air there was thick with malevolence being sent on its way to Enominat.
If I'd stayed there, I might be a dragon too.
Is having a vessel not enough to prevent a Moloch from transforming?
A vessel can reduce the effect, but not eliminate it. By stripping their Malakim of consciousness, the Abbey exorcists seem to be able to inhibit the transformation. But nothing in this world is guaranteed.
Can a dragon ever be changed back into a Moloch?
Nope. Just like with demons, there's no going back.
Do they still hold on to some part of who they were?
You saw that dragon. What do you think?
Well, that's...
But Zavid still won't kill it. Must be his creed at work.
Aizen, listen. Whatever business you and Zavid have with that dragon, I don't care. Do what you have to. But I won't tolerate you getting the rest of us involved in it again. Do I make myself clear?
You've got it.
Good. Now, let's get back to the Therian hunt. We'll regroup in Titania.
If what Aizen said is true, then could I wind up as a dragon someday? Or Aizen too?
I don't know.
Tight circles. Oh, perfect timing, Aizen. I's got a letter for you.
A letter?
Did you get a reply to that letter you sent? What's it say?
I know everything that you've done. Repent for your horrendous deeds, you monster.
What did you do, Aizen?
No idea. There's no sender written on here either.
Who would write something so awful?
Who cares? If I gave a damn about other people's feelings, I wouldn't be a pirate.
I suppose that's true.
Forget about it. What's the status of the other stuff?
The Palmier made it just fine. But we've run into some troubles finding the Nordals. My deepest apologies.
What are Nordals?
Nordals used to be given out by Empyrean temples. If you collect a set of four, you'd find happiness. Oh, so they said. Nowadays, there's only four left. Red, blue, green, and black. Even worse, nobody hardly knows nothing about them.
Dolls of the Empyreans. Do you think they're like that one we saw of Ominoch in that shop in Isolde?
Kind of. But these are less gloomy looking and more, how can I describe it?
Something like a quiet radiance.
A quiet radiance? That's perfect!
I think I get it.
I'd never have pegged you as a collector of religious claptrap, Aizen. Think they'll help keep the Reaper away?
Probably not. But in the off chance they actually work, they'll keep her safe.
Her? Hey, that letter Aizen sent off earlier was addressed to a woman, wasn't it?
Our little Lafayette is growing up.
No, I wasn't implying she was his girlfriend. Her writing just seemed more mature, and...
It's nothing like that. She's my younger sister.
I didn't know you had a sister.
She's the only family I have left. She and I live apart for various reasons.
I'm guessing your death curse is one of them, huh?
Mogilu!
So that's why. I'd be happy to help you look for those dolls, Aizen.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Okay, then. Thanks.
I saw Benwick and the other crew members get into a serious fight over whether cats or dogs were better. I don't get what the big deal is.
I can't believe you could say such a thing! No conflict is more perilous than the one that has dogged mankind since the dawn of civilization! In the shadow of every war are the battles of dog lovers and cat lovers. Between each side lies a divide, maybe not all that deep, but unbridgeable all the same. I'd say we're lucky that the squabble you saw didn't escalate into anything more serious.
I had no idea it was such a big deal. So what side do all of you fall on?
I am, without a doubt, a cat person. Cats and witches have a long history together.
Personally, I prefer dogs because they can cohabit with humans while following rules. But I like cats too, because they're cute.
What about you, Rokuro?
Sigure liked cats, so I don't. But I like dogs even less. Always wagging their tails for their masters.
I feel the same way. Dogs will trade anything for food. Learning tricks, wagging their tails, getting friendly, and in time, even forgetting to howl.
I think that's too cynical. Dogs make efforts to please humans so that we can live together. They're friendly and compassionate creatures.
Then does that make you a cat person, Aizen?
Actually, I like squirrels best. When I lived with my sister, the nearby forest had lots of nice, fluffy squirrels that would let me pet them.
This isn't about squirrels. It's about cats and dogs. You have to pick a side.
If I had to choose, yeah, it'd be cats. There's something lovable about the way they act, especially when you spoil them. Reminds me a lot of my sister.
What about you, Velvet? Cats or dogs?
Dogs. They don't betray you.
You always have to be so serious, don't you?
So Velvet and Eleanor like dogs, while Mogilu and Aizen prefer cats.
And Rokuro doesn't care for either one. That makes you our tiebreaker, kiddo. The fate of this showdown is in your hands.
It is?
Now that you're no longer the Abbey's dog, perhaps you're thinking of being one for Velvet's column?
What has that got to do with anything? We're just talking about which animal we like.
If you're getting so angry over this, he's going to have no choice but to pick dogs.
I just told you—
No more fighting! This is clearly getting out of hand, so why don't you all agree that you're Bienfu people and make up already?
And what makes you special enough to have Bienfu people?
Because I can be loyal like a dog, but also do my own thing like a cat. If you pick me, everybody wins.
I don't think it works that way.
I guess a dragon was a bit much to take on, even for the Reaper. You should get some rest.
We all should. I'll just get the crew started on readying the ship for our next departure.
All right. You go do that. Luffyset, you should get some rest too.
I'm fine. It's more important that I focus on finding an actual Therian this time. I'm going to take another try at sensing the Earth pulse points.
You're as stubborn as ever, Fee.
Kurigane, let me ask you something.
More complaining, is it?
Come on, don't be like that. Every time I turn around, Velvet or one of the pirates is telling me to go make some delivery to some island. I can never get a break.
Isn't that just a sign they think you're a dependable guy?
Maybe, but I don't see them sending you off on errands. It's like they take one look at your face and decide to leave you alone.
I don't have a face.
Oh, right, sorry. A slip of the tongue.
Maybe you just don't know how much work I do around here. It's more than you think. Anything to do with iron, I do it. Making tools, repairing things. What do you take me for? Some kind of cheeky freeloader? I don't even have cheeks.
You're too funny. But doesn't it ever annoy you to have all these kids giving you orders?
I've spent my entire life thinking of nothing but forging swords. It's been centuries since I've interacted with youngsters like them. They can be a hassle, but at least it's a new hassle.
Yeah, that's what I thought at first, so I went along with whatever they asked. But I've been too nice, so they keep pushing work onto me. Maybe if I hadn't been so helpful, they would have stayed out of my face like they stay out of yours.
I don't have a face.
That's not the point. Aren't you even listening to what I'm saying here?
You need to make up your mind. You and I got on this ship alongside these people, who are putting themselves in great danger in order to live the lives of their choosing. If you don't like it, then go on and get off this ship with your tail between your legs.
Yeah, except I don't have a tail right now.
Push yourself too hard now, Luffyset. You hear me?
I hear you. I just... I told everyone I could find the Therians, but... I've only sent us to the wrong places. Aizen, is there any way to boost Amalok's powers?
I guess it's okay for me to tell you this. The majority of Malakim today have their consciousnesses sealed away to be used as mere tools for the exorcists. But originally, Malakim were beings who received prayers from people, and in return bestowed their blessings upon nature and mankind.
So you're saying that when humans pray to a Moloch, the Moloch receives great strength?
Yes. In general, at least. Some Malakim, like me, buck the system and bring about misfortune rather than divine grace.
Oh, that's unfortunate. But who would ever pray to me?
Maybe you didn't lead us to any Therians, V, but it's not like we came back empty-handed. We found Orichalcum to use against Shigure, and we also learned we can hold our own against a dragon.
Velvet.
So where should we go next, V?
Northgand! There's a big Earth Pulse point north of Helavis!
Works for me. Aizen?
We can leave whenever you want. Doesn't matter to me.
And I'm all set. Let's make our way to the harbor.
When I say prayers, I don't mean outright worshiping. All I'm talking about are earnest thoughts and feelings directed at you.
I see. So I'm already receiving prayers then.
It's all thanks to you that construction of our hideout is proceeding so smoothly.
About that retractable ventilation shutter. Please, let me make a new one.
What? Why?
It's the hinges. When they move, it makes this...
Oh, come on! That's nothing! Besides, anything... More importantly, I'd love it if you made us a nice big pot and a...
Not happening. I can't focus with that incessant...
Fine! You can make a new shutter.
Can I also fix that autonomous hunter-killer anti-personnel?
That too? But you said you were satisfied with-
I was at first, but when I thought about it-
God, yes! Fix it before it kills us all!
Great. Okay. Shutter first.
Spinning death machine first!
Scout ship deployed.